Hello guys, welcome back. Speech by President Muhammadu Buhari at the signing into law of 2020 Appropriation Act. Presidential Villa, Abuja, Friday, 10th July 2019. Protocols. 1. It is my pleasure and honor to sign the Appropriation, that is the Repeal and Amendment Act 2020, into law today. I thank the distinguished Senate President, the Right Honorable Speaker of the House of Representatives, and all the distinguished and honorable leaders and members of the National Assembly for the prompt review and passage of the amendments to the 2020 Appropriation Act. 2. You will recall that I signed the 2020 Appropriation Act into law on Tuesday, 17th December 2019. However, it became necessary to revise the Appropriation Act 2020 in response to recent developments, in particular the COVID-19 pandemic. Crude oil prices in the world market declined sharply from a high of $72.20 per barrel in January 2020 to below $20 per barrel in April 2020 and have since remained around $40 per barrel. 3. Nigeria's crude oil production quota has been reduced as part of the efforts of the Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, to strengthen the oil markets. Global trade has generally been disrupted as almost all economies were locked down for protracted periods in the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic. 4. All these developments are plunging the global economy into recession, and Nigeria has not escaped the impact of this. In effect, the assumptions underlying the 2020 Appropriation Act are no longer sustainable. 5. It is therefore imperative to adjust our expected revenues considering the widespread disruptions in domestic and international economic activities due to the COVID-19 pandemic and the containment measures taken in response thereto. 6. Understandably, too, we needed to reallocate resources in the appropriation, that is Repeal and Amendment Act 2020, to ensure effective implementation of required health and emergency measures, as well as to mitigate the negative socio-economic effects of the COVID-19 pandemic. 7. The 2020 amended budget, which I have just signed into law today, underscores our administration's firm commitment to effectively contain the spread of COVID-19 and protect the lives and livelihood of our people. With these budget amendments, as well as our recently launched 2.3 trillion naira stimulus program, we are well positioned to safeguard the economy. 8. Considering recent budget implementation challenges, I have directed that efforts be made to ensure effective implementation of the appropriation, that is the Repeal and Amendment Act 2020, in order to realize its laudable objectives. 9. All ministers are to ensure that their ministries, departments, and agencies intensify capital project delivery efforts and fully cooperate with the Ministry of Finance, Budget, and National Planning to achieve the laudable objectives of the budget. 10. We have nevertheless made some progress in the implementation of the Appropriation Act 2020. As at 31st of May 2020, the sum of 253.33 billion naira have been released for the implementation of capital projects. 11. The Federal Ministry of Finance, Budget and National Planning is in the process of effecting budgetary releases that will ensure that all ministries, departments, and agencies receive at least 50% of their amended capital budgets by the end of this month. The Appropriation Act 2020 that I have just signed into law provides for aggregate expenditures of 10.81 trillion naira, which is an increase of 216 billion naira over the level of expenditure initially proposed in the 2020 Appropriation Act. The Honorable Minister of Finance, Budget and National Planning will provide further details of the 2020 amended budget. 13. I wish to acknowledge the efforts of the Ministry of Finance, Budget and National Planning, particularly the Budget Office of the Federation, and everyone who collaborated and worked conscientiously to produce the Appropriation Act 2020 that I have signed today. I thank all Nigerians for their understanding and unflinching support, especially during these difficult times. Thank you, and may God bless the Federal Republic of Nigeria. This was said at exactly 11:04 a.m. today. That is when President Muhammadu Buhari signed into law the revised 10.8 trillion naira budget for the year 2020. However, Nigerians have taken to social media to react. Duke Prince wrote, "Though I didn't read that long write-up, but tell President Buhari has been good to Nigerians despite insults, but he should work on security and also work on power so industries could grow. They should try pass a bill to punish fraudsters. The country is very difficult for the common man to grow," from a concerned Nigerian. Engrisa wrote, "Rubbish speech. Most blessed nation on earth turns out to be the world headquarters of poverty. To Fiakwa to all our leaders, both past and present." Another person wrote, Yoruba King King wrote, "I can confidently say that more than 50% of the population of this country has never felt any direct impact of this fraud called democracy since they were born. Year after year, they sign huge sum of cash as budgets, yet never felt by the poor masses. The rich keeps getting richer, while the poor gets poorer. Many youths are left to fend for themselves by joining kidnapping gangs, Boko Haram and Yahoo boys. But all this is about to change, because God will raise a good shepherd who is going to lead the sheep of Israel. Hold on a little bit, O ye poor of the land. Just a little while, and your Savior shall come. But first, you will behold the punishment of your oppressors." ODJ 124 wrote, "Well done, Mr. President." Halen J wrote, "Well, I have nothing to say." Why Angelic Damsel said, "Nowadays, I see clips and not speeches of the president. Everything is different." Another person wrote, "Together we can make..." That is Fresh Momo, according to what he wrote. "Together we can make Nigeria better. Nigerian youths, drop your differences and unite. God bless Nigeria." Y Silver Line said, "What useless speech. I won't even bother myself believing whatever he had just said." And that person have a very strong one here saying, "Nigerians like voting for premises. To be honest, we need leaders that can at least solve just one major problem. Electricity, healthcare, roads, education, employment and wealth creation, security. just solve only one. But no, they will make all the promises like they can solve all the problems within 4 years. Nigerians are the smartest, at the same time, most foolish set of people alive. People will spend their life not having some basic needs mentioned above. How can giants of Africa and its citizens be satisfied being referred to as a third world nation? What lessons are we passing to the next generation when we practice tribalism and hate? Wow, that was a very strong one. So guys, if you have anything to say, drop your reactions in the comment section. And don't forget to please subscribe to this channel. Thank you very much.